This video is sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends, a brand new collection RPG with awesome 3D graphics, huge crazy boss fights, and more than 400 champions for you to collect and customize. Raid is like the classic RPG and strategy games you love, but on your phone. You'll be hooked by the amazing storyline, the crazy battles, and the insane level of details on the champions. It's like a AAA game, but free to play. And look at this amazing score on the Play Store. Go to the description and click on our special link to instantly get 50,000 silver and a free epic champion as part of the new player program to start your journey. Good luck, and I'll see you in Raid Shadow Legends. It's said that we know more about outer space than we do about our own oceans, and there's a lot of truth to that statement. While it's relatively easy to scan the skies with telescopes or even to put satellites into orbit that can help us make discoveries about the void outside our planet, getting research equipment, let alone men, to survive the trek to the bottom of the ocean can be extremely challenging. And nowhere is it more challenging than at the deepest point in the ocean, the Mariana Trench. But what if you wanted to do more than just visit? What would it take to actually live there? Fantasies of escaping the world above for a life beneath the waves are as old as humanity, though most of our viewers are probably best familiar to the idea through the BioShock franchise, an award-winning video game that took place in an underwater utopia that predictably turned into a chaotic mess of violence and greed. Still, the idea of living beneath the waves caught the public's imagination, much as 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea had done decades prior. In real life, many futurists believe that humanity will be able to move into the oceans far sooner than it will move into the stars. Some architecture firms have even drawn up plans for floating cities, along with underwater metropolises, which could be made completely self-sufficient. With most of the world's mineral, oil, and natural gas wealth resting at the bottom of the ocean, the seas are a vast gold mine waiting to be tapped. However, even the most ambitious plans to move humanity under the waves stop far short of going somewhere as deep as the Mariana Trench. One day, you decide that you've had it with humanity. You don't want to see or hear from another living person ever again. You check Twitter and discover that Elon Musk's one-way trip to Mars is still no sooner to being a reality, and realize that if you want to get away, you're going to have to go down and not up. Really, really down, to the deepest point in the ocean. At 36,201 feet, you can't get any deeper than the Mariana Trench. The trench is so deep, in fact, that if you were to put Mount Everest inside it, there would still be 1.2 miles of water above it. And if you're worried about living space, well, the trench is 1,580 miles long and 43 miles wide, so there's plenty of elbow room to go around. Like planning any move, your first concern is going to be for shelter, and at the bottom of the trench, you're going to need one hell of a shelter to keep you from being squashed like an overripe tomato. That's because the pressure at the bottom of the trench is an incredible 15,750 pounds per square inch, or about 1,000 times the pressure at sea level. That's the total weight of all the water pressing down on you from above, and at those pressures, your skull would implode instantly. To resist all that pressure, you're going to need specially constructed habitats that can withstand incredible stresses, and luckily for you, we already have some experience in building things sturdy enough to keep humans alive in the dark depths. In 2012, James Cameron took a break from making sequels to his Ferngully ripoff, we mean homage, to fulfill a lifelong goal of descending to the bottom of Challenger Deep, the deepest part of the Mariana Trench. To achieve the feat, he made the journey inside a cigar-shaped submersible, although the actual crew compartment was a sphere that was only 43 inches wide. That's because spheres are the strongest shape for resisting pressure, as they help to distribute the pressure load much in the same way as an arch. While other, more traditional shapes are possible with today's engineering, making any other shape craft would require three or more times the wall thickness. With walls already several inches thick, your habitat is going to have to be a sphere. So you'll have to get used to living in what will essentially be a giant hamster ball. Of course, the size of that ball will also be very limited, as increasing the size of the sphere will exponentially decrease how effectively it spreads out the pressure pushing down on it. Realistically, you're going to be living in a sphere that's 4 to 5 feet across, maximum. Maybe you're a fan of tight spots, though, and don't feel particularly claustrophobic. We certainly hope not, because exiting your habitat will be 100% impossible and result in instant death. Still, you've sorted out the living situation, and with such tight quarters, you'll save a fortune on furniture. Food and water are going to be next. Water seems obvious, it's all around you, and many modern ships employ desalination systems to turn salty seawater into fresh water. Except it's not really going to be as easy as it seems, because physically getting the water from outside to inside your habitat is going to be an extremely difficult thing to do. That's because the immense pressure is constantly pushing down. So the moment you turn on a tap to take water in, you're going to have the entire ocean trying to rush through your pipes. Taking water in from outside is a no-go, so you're going to have to do like astronauts and recycle the water you bring with you. This means sweat and urine, which you'll be running through a special filtration system to constantly recycle. Lucky for you, the system mostly eliminates the taste of urine from the water. Mostly. Also, showers are going to be out of the question, but with enough room for only one person, there'll be no company to complain about your smell. Food is also going to be a problem, and that's because the bottom of the ocean is very much like a desert that's broken up occasionally by pockets of life. Those pockets of life spring up around volcanic vents, which spit out water full of gases and minerals which the local life has adapted to consume. You could choose to settle near one of those vents to have handy access to tube worms and all types of crabs, except the water temperature around those vents reaches hundreds of degrees and will eventually destroy your habitat. Instead, you'll likely have to do much the same as the other inhabitants of the extreme deep – wait for food to come down from above. Known as marine snow, the constant snow-like debris that hangs in the water at the bottom of the ocean is in fact the physical remains of dead life from the top. While far too small for you to eat, you could always try to snag a wandering hagfish with a robotic probe. You could luck out though and stumble across a whale carcass, featuring enough rotting meat to keep you satisfied for weeks. Once the dead whale is gone though, you'll be forced to sit tight and hope for another. And given that scientists believe it can take weeks for the carcasses to float down to the bottom, you'll be waiting quite a while for your next meal. With water just 1 degree above freezing, you're gonna have to keep warm, or you'll die of hypothermia long before you die of starvation. Unfortunately for you, battery power is only going to last so long, and with zero sunlight reaching these extreme depths, you can forget about solar. Instead, you'll likely have to rely on an exterior water wheel of sorts, which turns in the current and generates electricity. This will likely not offer much wattage though, as the water at the bottom of Challenger Deep can be extremely still, and currents are weak. Instead, you may have to make your own electricity by attaching internal pedals that can turn the exterior water wheel, generating an electrical charge. The process isn't very efficient though, and you'll have to spend the rest of your life constantly pedaling, or risk losing power and freezing to death. Lastly, there's one very serious problem which we think you might likely overlook, and that's the issue of going to the bathroom. Once more, you can forget about plumbing of any sort, as the moment you flush, you're gonna have everything you just deposited blasted into your face and your habitat flood as the ocean rushes in. This actually happened to a German submarine in World War II, and the sub was forced to surface and its crew captured simply because one sailor didn't know how to properly work the toilet. While a regular submarine can simply store waste and expel it at depths with lower pressures, if you tried to do the same, you'd run into a similar problem as trying to turn on a tap to bring in outside water to desalinate and drink it, namely, that you'd immediately flood your entire habitat. Instead of flushing, you're gonna have to keep your waste inside with you, and that presents a whole host of problems which we really don't want to get into, but should seem pretty obvious. The good news is that if you did flush, the pressure is so great and the water would rush in with so much force that it would cut your body in half and kill you instantly, thus cutting short your miserable time at the bottom of the ocean. Life at the bottom of the Mariana Trench would basically be impossible with modern technology, unless you didn't mind living in a cramped hamster ball that's slowly filled with your own waste. Perhaps in the future, it may be truly possible for humanity to move beneath the waves, and one day, we might all be enjoying an undersea, poop-free lifestyle free from the tyranny of the topside world, until we discover plasmids and all murder each other, that is. How would you survive at the bottom of the Mariana Trench? Would you kindly let us know in the comments? And as always, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more great content.